With everyone talking about cell testing, are you ready to get started with your level 3 virtualization journey? I'll show you how to quickly get started with the integration use case of vVIRTUALtarget. Hi, my name is Marius and I'm part of the vVIRTUALtarget development team. I've prepared a sample which demonstrates the workflow and the vector tools that are involved in creating a level 3 virtual ECU using the integration use case of vVIRTUALtarget. For the integration use case, we are utilizing the DaVinci tooling. In the DaVinci Configurator 5, basic software is configured and generated. Additionally, the DaVinci developer is used to create the software component design, and after that, vVIRTUALtarget analyzes the configuration and generates the development environment for your virtual ECU. You can choose between Visual Studio Solutions, CMake or Bazel as your environment to build and debug the Level 3 virtual ECU. You can now use your vECU in CANoe for testing, debugging and analyzing your code. Alright, with this idea in mind, we can see how this works in practice. As mentioned before, we'll start with the tool where the basic software is configured. The DaVinci Configurator. In this setup, we are using the dual target approach where we have a single project for the real and virtual ECU. This means that we have our CAN module for the real target as well as the VTT CAN from the vVIRTUALtarget MCAL. The additional modules for the virtual MCAL are synchronized automatically with the real target modules and only a few parameters need to be configured manually. In this example, I demonstrate this with a single parameter, the dev error detection. As soon as I change the parameter in the real target module, the change is automatically synchronized to the virtual memcal module. With that, we finish the configuration of the basic software as well as the design of our application. So let's generate the basic software for the vECU. In this generation dialog, you can see that we can switch between the targets of this configuration. By selecting vVIRTUALtarget as the generation target, we generate the code which reflects our configuration, including the vVIRTUALtarget MCAL. During the generation process, vVIRTUALtarget is called to prepare the instrumentation of code for our open port and port monitoring features. After that, we switch to vVIRTUALtarget itself. As you can tell, one primary input to the project is the DPA file. This is essentially the persistency format of the DaVinci Configurator 5 project and references the ECU configuration that we just finished and generated code for. The second important input is the implementation of our application layer, which we already potentially tested on a level 1 virtualization. You might want to configure some other details, but in this case, we can switch to the Build tab. Here we select the desired target platform and we choose Visual Studio as our development environment, which we can use later to debug our virtual ECU. Now we start the build process of vVIRTUALtarget. During that process, vVIRTUALtarget analyzes our inputs and creates a development environment for us. With this configuration, vVIRTUALtarget already calls the compiler for us. This means that we now have our vECU already available here. Let's go to CANoe to see our virtual ECU in action. I have already prepared a small configuration, including a reminding bus simulation created with the CANoe's model generation wizard. By the way, you can also generate a basic configuration from vVIRTUALtarget itself. To this reminding bus simulation we already have, we can very easily add our vECU by creating a new node in the network and then referencing the virtual ECU to be used with that node. As we are on the Windows system, our vECU software is inside a DLL. This is the main artifact of our system under test we built using Visual Studio. And that's already it. We have successfully added our vECU to CANoe, so let's start the simulation. Our vECU now participates in communication on the CAN bus like any other node. While the vECU is running, we could now start automated tests or debug it easily with the aforementioned Visual Studio solution. Of course, we can also add a real-bus component to the setup if we want. This was a quick demo of our integration use case. We hope this video helps you on your way to a virtual ECU and enables you to start cell testing. If you have any further questions, please consult our knowledge base or contact my support colleagues. If you want to explore our use case for creating a level 1 virtualization, make sure to check out our other vVIRTUALtarget tutorial. And don't forget to subscribe to the Vector Tech Tutorial channel. And hit the bell.